back to More Team Music. In today's theory episode, we're going to be looking at word painting. As always, let's start at the beginning. So what is word painting? It's a technique used in music writing that reflects the literal meaning of the words or story behind the song. Word painting, or tone painting, goes all the way as far back as these guys doing Gregorian chants in the early days of the church. It then continued to be used in Italian and English madrigals, which were just types of songs, and then on into the Baroque period. Here's a well-known Baroque example of word painting in Handel's Messiah. Have a listen and see what you can hear. In the melody, the word valley ends on a low note, and it begins on a high note, so it creates a valley. And on the opposite end of the scale, pardon the pun, the word mountain has a peak in the melody, so it looks like, you guessed it, a mountain. And would you look at that? Same again with the word hill, it's just a small mountain. Okay, here's a really simple one. On the word low, we have, you guessed it, a low note. So it's not just the notes that connote word painting, it's also the way that they're played. So things like dynamics and articulation. Okay, let's get into the good music. Here's one that we'll all know. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth. Have you ever sung along to this and thought, what on earth is the fourth or the fifth? Well, you're about to find out. It's actually describing the chord functions. So here we have the fourth chord, fifth chord, shift down to minor, and back up to major. Another really popular way of using word painting today is the words high and stop. Have you ever noticed these words being used before? How about this throwback song? So we heard the word high, and you guessed it, she sang a high note. And same again when she sang down, the notes went down. Let's see if you can get this next one. Okay, we're getting the hang of this now. Let's see if you can guess what will happen on the word stop. This is getting a bit crazy. I don't know about you, but I hadn't noticed these before now. What about this absolute classic? As they sing the words, you raise me up, the chords and notes go up. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. Here's one with a change of harmony. As he sings, I'm going to make a change, there's a key change. Okay, for our last example, let's end on a high, or should I say, a low. That's it for today's theory video. Had you noticed word painting being used before? Leave a comment below of other pieces that you can find word painting in. And also leave a comment below of what you'd like to learn next. Thanks for watching. Bye!